Rodney King to the Detroit Riot in 1967, the Newark Riot in 1967, Harlem Riot in 1964, Watts in 1965, every single one of those riots was a result of police brutality. That is the common thread.
It would be a mistake to say, as many people do in the current context, that, oh, if you're against the police, then you're against law and order, and these are hardworking civil servants, they're putting their lives on the line for you every day. And, you know, that's true. People who join the police do so, you know, to do these sorts of things. But if you dismiss black complaints of mistreatment by police as being completely rooted in our modern context, then you're missing the point completely. There has never been a period in our history where the law and order branch of the state has not operated against the freedoms, the liberties, the options, the choices that have been available for the black community, generally speaking. And to ignore that racial heritage, to ignore that historical context, means that you can't have an informed debate about the current state of blacks and police relationship today, because this didn't just appear out of nothing. This is the product of a centuries-long historical process, and to not reckon with that is to shut off solutions.